cardinal addition is defined as the cardinality of the disjoint union of the arguments. Cardinal multiplication is the cardinality of the Cartesian product of the arguments. Note how cardinal operations are different from their ordinal counterparts. Cardinal addition and multiplication are abelian monoids. The proof follows since disjoint union and Cartesian product have the properties up to bijections. In fact, the relation between ordinal and cardinal operations is easily illustrated in proposition 42.3. On finite cardinals, the cardinal operations are the usual addition and multiplication of naturals. Every infinite cardinal is a limit ordinal. The proof is by contradiction, and it follows as an easy consequence of cardinal arithmetic. The product of an infinite cardinal alpha with itself is alpha. as a corollary, when alpha and beta are infinite cardinals, their sum and product are both equal to their maximum. In fact, the same holds if at least one of them is infinite. The general form of Cantor's theorem is, for every set A, A is strictly less than the power set of A. For every cardinal, there is a bigger cardinal. This fact is obvious when the cardinal is finite. If it is infinite, take the sets of its well orderings, which is non-empty. By replacement, the set of ordinals isomorphic to these well orderings is defined. Its union is an ordinal which is strictly greater than every element. So it is a cardinal, and by definition it is greater than alpha.